Hello. For the last hour, I've been trying to make a texture for my server for specifically a potion with a custom texture and custom potion overlay. I have looked up many tutorials online, and a lot of them are very confusing, a lot of them are outdated. So, in this one, I'm just going to show you how I worked it out over the course of an hour. Now, some of the things I say might be redundant. You might not have to put them in specific folders. Maybe it just has to be inside of the Optifine folder. I don't know. Just bear with me. If you do it the way I do it, you'll get it to work. That's all that matters. So, I'm gonna switch on back to my desktop. If you're this far into making a resource pack that you're making CIT files, I hope that you know how to do it already. If you don't, I'm not gonna explain it. Just have your pack meta. And your assets folder, your Minecraft folder. These are the two folders that I used that worked. So in your Optifine, in your CIT folder, if you don't have a CIT folder, make one. Okay, in here, we're gonna need two files. We're gonna need the .json folder, which is a model folder, and we're gonna need your properties folder. If you've made CITs before, you know that property files are commonly what you use. But I, for some reason, with Optifine or CIT, something. I don't fully understand this. I'm fairly new to this. It only uses one of the textures and it sets it as the overlay. You cannot have both in a properties folder, which is where the model folder will come in. So make a properties file. If you don't know how to, just download Notepad++. Make a new file and then save it as a dot properties. Or if you go to properties here and then you rename this final part to dot properties, then click OK. I mean, that won't work. If I let me show you as because this works the same if you're making a dot JSON file. So I'll change this into a JSON file. So let's just rename the end part to dot JSON. Click OK. It will say this will change the file extension. It might become usable. Just click yes. Now it's a .json file. But we need a properties file, so we're going to change that back to .properties. Wonderful, wonderful. Yes. And now we have our properties file. Inside of the properties file, the type is an item, so type equals item. Match items potion. Model. So this is the JSON file that we're going to make in a second. Mine is called Gorvard underscore potion dot JSON. You can have it be called anything you want, so long as it's a JSON file. It has to be the same name as the properties file. Both of them have to have the same name, just with a different extension at the end. And then this is for doing lore. There are other ways to do this if you want it based on name. I'm fairly certain it's mbt.display.name. We will try that actually. Why not? While we're here, we may as well make it so it has to have both requirements. So let's say Gorvar and then test is the name of the item. So we'll save that. Next up, we need the JSON file. I've already shown you how to make a JSON file just a minute ago. So make one, call it the same thing as your properties file, and inside you're going to want this. It has to be spaced out this way. I will have this in the description of the video. Just copy paste it. All you gotta do is make sure that you rename this one. Now this is confusing. Okay, here's where things get weird. The overlay, for some reason, the layer zero, it doesn't have to be called overlay. The layer zero has to be this. This is just because I was messing around for so long. Your main potion file has to be what you put in layer zero. In layer one, you want the potion overlay. If you want to do it the way I've done it, will guarantee to work. So do that. And then save this. Now, you do not, unlike most CIT things, you do not put the texture here. Instead, if you don't have a textures file already, make one. Inside of it, you want to make an items folder. And then you want to put both textures inside of here. Okay, back to the game. I'm gonna turn on our new resource pack that we've just made, backpack. We'll let that load. Okay, we're going to grab ourselves a potion. Let's just grab a water bottle, it'll work, or a mundane bottle. We're going to do item lore, add Gorvar, and then item name, what did we say, it was test. Watch that not work. Why doesn't that work? Okay, this is not the right folder. Is it because it needs to just be that? Let's try that. Okay. That has worked, but not in the way it should have. Okay, as you can see here, something has gone amiss because the overlay is being funky. Why is it being funky? I don't understand. Okay, we're just going to swap these. I know I said earlier that you have to do it the way I've said, but clearly I was lying. Okay, reload the texture pack with F3 and T. And what would you like that? It's working. Thank goodness. And just to prove that it is working because of the name and the thing, we're going to name this one Gorvar. And we're going to give this the name of test. And then if I add test to this one and then Gorvar to this one, there you go. And this will work with any color. And it works. That's how you do it. Yay. If you don't know how to, if you're not using a plugin to add lore and names, there is a, here's me having previously had to look it up, there is a way if you go to MC Stacker and we go to give item, you give yourself a potion, and then you can set the lore and the name here. What you gotta do, so let's do the same thing we've just done. So the name is test, the lore is Gorvar. Copy this. I have to put Minecraft before because I'm using essentials. And there you go, it worked. I hope this video, even though it's messy and there are errors in it, has helped you. If it has, let me know in the comments. You don't gotta subscribe or anything. Let me know. I'd be happy to hear that someone has not gone through the badness that I've just gone through.